Hi everybody, I'm Paula. We're here at Ensancha 14 in Guatemala. And we have this interview powered by Attitude Radio. Hi Pastor, thank you for being here with us. Could you please tell us your name and tell us where you're from and the name of your ministry?
My name is Bill Winston. I'm from Chicago. And my ministry is Church is Living Word Christian Center. And the ministry that we have is Bill Winston Ministries. That's one of the main ministries that we have.
Thank you very much. Can you tell us a little bit of how this invitation happened? It's the second time we have you here in Guatemala. How do you meet Pastor Cash? How do you end up here at Ensancha?
Well, I think it was a divine appointment. I think God had a hand in it. I was looking for another speaker speaking the daytime in our annual, what we call International Faith Conference. It goes on every year in September. And I was talking to one of our pastors who is a part of a group that we have, and he's in Miami. And he mentioned Pastor Cash. And I had heard about Pastor Cash before, and I said, well, let me pray on it and see what the Lord says. I prayed on it, the Lord says, go and see, can he come and speak? So he did, and came and spoke. And when he did, he spoke at our church, and I tell you, it was just such a blessing to everybody. And so that's when we really start to get to know one another. Now, before that, I knew of him through Pastor Keith Hershey, who introduced us to him and to Pastor Lopez. And so as a result of that, we have become very good friends.
Good. And how do you end up here in Guatemala coming to be a part of Ensancha?
Well, I believe that it's because God has an appointed time for me to be here because of the word that he's given me. When I last came here last year, I taught on the blessing. Mm-hmm. And this year, I'm continuing with the blessing, but I'm going into this area we call taking ownership.
Yes.
That God has given us the entire estate of the earth. Now, he wants us to do things with it.
It was a very powerful message last night. Could you tell us a little bit of how do you establish God's kingdom here on earth?
Well, the first thing that people have to realize is that the kingdom of God is within you. This is in Luke chapter 17 and verses 20 through 21. And this kingdom of God in you is God establishing his government inside of every believer. Mm-hmm. And what's in you really is a thing that affects what's outside of you. We have to understand the kingdom and how the kingdom functions and the kingdom process. He said, the sower soweth the word. God is bringing us back to operate on the level of our Father. And that is the level of speaking things into existence. Whosoever shall say to this mountain, whatsoever things you desire when you pray, believe you, you receive them. And this idea of whatever's inside of us coming outside of us really is establishing the Garden of Eden everywhere we go. Because he said the tree is going to be known by its fruit. And so whatever is in us, which I call the root, really establishes a fruit outside of us. Let me give you just one example. And that is in the city of Chicago, in certain areas. Now, there's still some areas that are blighted. We call them, people might call them ghetto areas and things like that. People are very poor. And if you look at the buildings, the windows are broken out and so forth like that. If you just interview the people and talk to them, you'll see that their hearts are broken down. And whatever's in them is manifesting outside of them. So what happens in the kingdom is once you get born again, you get the kingdom in you. Now the kingdom, wherever you go, manifests outside of you. You can go to a job, for example. The kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And people in that job will be all nervous and everything, but when you get there, you stay there a few days, all of a sudden, there's a peace that comes to that job. Why? Because we are designed to spread this kingdom wherever we go. One man said it like this. His name was R.W. Schambach. He was a very, very famous, well-known, should I say, evangelist throughout the world. And he passed, went on to be with the Lord recently. But he used to say something. He said, you don't have any problems. All you need is faith in God. And that faith is the holder of your destiny. That once you come into this world, it's going to take faith to operate in this world, to receive the inheritance that God has for you. And it's going to be faith that's going to take you to your destiny. So I want to let people know that it's not according to your background, it's not according to your country, it's not according to your bank account, it's not according to how well you speak English, it's not according to your own pedigree or your own whatever you could put up there. It's according to your faith, be it unto you. And I just find that using my faith, it got my wife and our house debt-free. It's got us our cars. It's got us the ministry airplane. It's got us buildings. It's got us shopping malls. It's got faith did all of this. I sure didn't have enough money to do it. God has never asked me to do something big that I've had the money to do. He has never asked me to do that because it's faith that becomes the currency of the kingdom. So I'd like to just say to somebody that's watching now or listening to me by radio or internet, you don't have any problems. All you need is faith in God. Your labor is not how long you can work a job. True enough, work is good, but your labor is in the Word, because in that Word comes faith. And when faith is activated, the power of God goes into operation, and whatever you lack, it will supply. So this is, I believe, your season. This is the time that you're not going to be depending anymore on a system that's failing, on maybe relatives that somehow just can't make it themselves. But what you're going to depend on now is your faith. And when you get that faith and resolve in your heart that God is not only your source, but your only source, watch your life soar. I want to pray with you right now. Father, I pray for everyone that's in the sound of my voice. I pray that no longer, Lord, they look to this fallen world as their source. No longer will they be troubled by what's going on around them and in the world today. But now, Lord, they'll look to you, the author and finisher of our faith. And Father, with that faith comes positivism, the I can. And let them see how great they are, Lord. Let them see the seeds of greatness that have been sown in them from the foundation of the world. And Father, we pray for every person that's watching me now, success. We pray the blessing of Abraham on them, that their lives will never be the same. We thank you for it, and we call it done in Jesus' name. Amen.